I need you in every part of my life. I want to be kissed. I want to pull your head down on my heart and hold it very close and cradle you there for hours. You blessed thing. Love you. Love you. Your ownest in the world.
Have you ever fallen in love head over heels with someone? Have you ever been in a relationship of which you thought, this is it, my one true love? Imagine a young couple, a young American couple with big hopes and big dreams. He wants to travel the world and become a famous writer. She, having lived through a tragic, lonely youth with her hard, unloving mother, just wants to go wherever he goes and build a family together. She has quite a musical talent, but she is too shy to actually pursue a career as a concert pianist. He's 22, she some years older. He has the dark, handsome looks of a young movie star, while she has thick, auburn hair, lovely high cheekbones, and soft, dark brown eyes that have the capacity to break his heart. As she once wrote to him, the world is a jail, and we're going to break it together. He is called Ernest. Her name is Hadley, which he lovingly shortens to Hash. Ever since they met at a friend's party in Chicago, they know they belong together. On the 3rd of September 1921, they get married. An author that they know advises them to move to Paris, the epicenter of literature and arts at that moment. So, only 3 months after their wedding, they board a ship that will bring them to Europe. It's the 22nd of December 1921 when the couple arrives in Paris. As the young man suggests in a newspaper piece sometime later, they both feel homesick at first. Paris with the snow falling, he writes. Paris with the big charcoal braziers outside the cafes glowing red. At the cafe tables, men huddled, their coat collars turned up, while they finger glasses of Grog American and the newsboys shout the evening papers. Snow is never more beautiful than in the city. It is wonderful in Paris to stand on a bridge across the Seine, looking up through the softly curtaining snow, past the grey bulk of the Louvre, up the river, spanned by many bridges and bordered by the grey houses of old Paris, to where Notre Dame squats in the dusk. It is very beautiful in Paris, and very lonely at Christmas time. You never know what Christmas is, until you lose it in some foreign country. The couple spends their first night in Paris at the Hôtel Jacob, and they will continue to live there until, a few weeks later, they find an apartment at 74 Rue Cardinal Lemoine. It is a small, furnished apartment with no running water and shared toilets, but they have all they need there to lead a wonderful life together. The apartment even has a piano for Hadley. In a few years' time, the young man will go on to become the world-famous writer Ernest Hemingway. His years in Paris will have an unforgettable impact. He will carry the memories with him for the rest of his life. More than 30 years later, a few years before his death, he decides to capture his memories of Paris in a memoir called A Movable Feast. Up to this day, it is one of the most beautiful books ever written about Paris. Full of romance, full of love, between Ernest Hemingway and Hadley Richardson.